Poppy is a champion that Riot has been talking about reworking for an astonishingly long amount of time. For years, she's plagued the game with an all-or-nothing type kit where she'll either feel super OP as she charges into your team and teamfights one-shotting the AD carry, or she'll feel incredibly weak if you pick her up yourself and you don't know how to not get completely bullied out of the game in laning phase. Well, after a very long wait, the rework is finally up on the live client, and today we're going to be taking a look at it in a champion review, seeing just how well Riot did with what was probably an incredibly big project for them. Now, in my opinion, this Poppy redesign has two major elements to it that Riot hit with varying levels of success, a stylistic element and a gameplay element. Unfortunately, I would say there's a few instances where Riot made design decisions that were more based around keeping her thematically correct rather than doing what makes the most sense from a balance or gameplay perspective, but we'll talk about this a little bit later. Let's go ahead and jump into some comparisons with Poppy's new abilities. Poppy's new passive Iron Ambassador seems built to make up for her years of struggling in laning phase. With no sustain, she's had a lot of issues in the past against other top laners who've had all sorts of ways to harass her with solid damage, while also being able to outsustain her and her health potions if she fights back. This new passive is built to counter that. It seems really one-dimensional at first as something you just use to last hit minions if you're struggling in laning phase. You know, you get the bonus range so it's easier to last hit, plus you get a shield so you can just run up and last hit some more without having to worry about getting harassed while doing so. However, this ability actually has a lot more depth than you might first think. That shield is pretty powerful, meaning that you can just use it to not get harassed while last hitting, but you can also use it to approach opponents and harass them with your E and Q after last hitting something while they can't really fight back. The ability itself also does a fair bit of damage, meaning that landing it on an opponent can be good harass, especially since it triggers that currently very strong mastery, Thunderlord's Decree, if you have it stacked up. It might seem like a little bit of a cop-out if you think about it, a champion that traditionally struggles with getting bullied in laning phase due to being melee. Let's just fix that by letting them be ranged once every 16 seconds. Yeah, it's a bit of a simple way to fix it, but the implementation of it is good and the ability has a lot more depth than you may first realize, all while still being fairly simple. Moving on to her next ability, her new Q, I would say, is a pretty nice upgrade compared to the old one. The old one simply dealt an absurd amount of damage that was difficult to build against, while this one still has the potential to deal a fair amount of damage, but requiring a little more skill on your part or misplay on your opponents to land both charges. Also, it's nice to see that it now has a slow, giving Poppy some much-needed reliable CC. One interesting thing about this ability is, theoretically, because it gives Poppy a little bit of AoE, it allows her to battle an issue that she's struggled with all her life, wave clear. However, this is one of the things I was talking about when I wrote that little intro mentioning how certain elements of her kit don't translate perfectly well into her gameplay. If Riot was trying to give her a nice bit of wave clear, then they technically succeeded by reworking her Q in this way, but the way the damage is dealt through this Q is a little difficult to actually get the last hits with. The Q has two charges that, unless you're building full damage, both charges won't be enough to kill even just the ranged creeps of a minion wave due to the ability dealing 80% damage to minions. That means that you have to get at least one auto attack on each of them to collect your gold, which is difficult to do without something killing at least one of the creeps. This might just be something that you need to dedicate some time to get a better understanding of how to clear minion waves with this ability. Maybe I'm just bad at it right now, but at the same time, it feels difficult to wrap your head around and a little counterintuitive. I found it awkward to use. It seems like Riot knew what they were doing in making this a little hard to clear waves with by giving it that 80% damage reduction to minions, but that just doesn't make much sense to me. It's not like this is a massive AoE that's going to be used to hit multiple champions in teamfights. If you're going to give the Q a small AoE, it should be for the purpose of clearing minions, which is already a little awkward to do with the two charges. This is still an ability, though, that fits the kit really well. It just possibly could have been implemented better if it was specifically meant to be giving Poppy that much-needed wave clear. Moving on, though, Poppy's new W is Steadfast Presence. Over the years, there's been a bit of a power creep in League, with so many new champions having movement abilities. Whether that's Gnar and his little hop, or something as crazy as Yasuo's dashes, it's nice to see a solid counter finally being introduced to the game in the form of Poppy's new W. This ability, I would say, is very well designed. It's something that's super rewarding if you're able to land it on someone as they try and dash somewhere, but it's also pretty punishing not really doing that much if you miss it. I like the implementation of it on a tank like Poppy, but I'm also really interested to see if Riot might utilize this kind of ability on other releases or reworks in the future. It's also worth noting that Riot did a really good job of simplifying Poppy's old passive of getting tankier and harder to kill at low health, and moving it over as a new passive for the W. All in all, I'd say this is a really good ability, very skill-oriented, creative, and satisfying. Next up, we're going to be glossing quickly over Poppy's E. Probably the best decision that Riot made when reworking Poppy was not really touching her E ability. Heroic Charge needed a few bug fixes and a visual update, but other than that, it's probably the most unusual and cool ability in Poppy's kit, so it's good to see them not really change it. It's also cool to see it get added benefits from ramming opponents into walls, since the stun duration is a little bit longer, half a second at max rank, and you also get a super punishing combo of guaranteeing landing both charges of your Q if you're able to get that stun. And then of course we have the ultimate Keeper's Verdict. Poppy's new ultimate was probably the ability I was talking about the most when I said at the start of this video that Riot made some design choices that were more thematic and fit really well theoretically while not always transferring perfectly to the actual game. Poppy's old ultimate was about taking champions out of a teamfight, either by taking herself out of a teamfight so opponents couldn't CC or damage her by ulting someone well, or quite often bursting down AD and AP carries super quickly, effectively taking them out of teamfights too. This new ultimate had a very similar concept and idea behind it, taking champions out of fights by literally knocking them back to their base. However, this ability is something that I haven't really found myself using that effectively. More often than not, I'm always scared to use it, worried that it might accidentally AoE a target my team is focusing and about to kill. This is especially true since it's a skill shot. I mean, it can't go through targets. I'm only ever really able to hit enemy champions in the front of a teamfight, which is most often who we're focusing. I typically end up using the ultimate as a weird knockup tool to stall for cooldowns or reposition myself in fights, and unfortunately, that's really it. I'm not too sure whether this is the fault of a cool theoretical design that just didn't translate to gameplay, or maybe I need to work on mastering the ability more. I'm not too sure, honestly. Overall though, I think this redesign was really nice and well done, but I have a few nitpicks here and there with how Poppy plays that's probably going to keep me away from the champion in the future. In addition to everything I mentioned, the thing I really liked about the old Poppy and the entire reason I did a full-fledged guide on her at one point was she was a super weird hyper carry that dealt insane damage while still being kind of balanced in a way where she was sort of like a glass cannon who was just broken and useless by endgame if she couldn't make it through laning phase. I can understand how that style of play can easily break the game, and the reason for the rework was completely justifiable and understandable, but Poppy doesn't have that much appeal to me anymore with those elements of her kit gone. Riot did a good job of keeping the Iron Ambassador theme in her kit, and most of these abilities are very unusual, creative, and unique, but for whatever reason she just doesn't seem to flow as well or captivate me with her current style of play, which of course is perfectly fine. I didn't get to play that much of Poppy before making this video due to an unfortunate family tragedy that occurred this week, so I'm not the most experienced player with the rework, I must admit here. Feel free to leave your own thoughts in the comments down below if you think I missed something or if one of my small nitpicky criticisms has helped out with a little more dedication and uncovering how she plays. Anyway though, I hope you guys all enjoyed watching this champion rework review. I'll see you all in the next video, but until then, thank you very much for watching. Good luck in solo queue, and have a wonderful day. Alright, kick back, relax, and let's hit it again. While you go tell your mother, father, cousin, the kid, and your other friends that don't even have a clue what this doo-doo crew is about to do. You know it ain't fool's gold, this is kryptonite.